What does an archaeologist do? Okay, what does an archaeologist do? Now, I think a lot of us have sort of a cliche image in our mind that they like swashbuckle a lot. And they're in some like romantic locale, like the jungle or the desert, right? And sometimes there are aspects of truth in that. But much more specifically, how do we kind of angle our career? What do we look for? How do we set this up on a day-to-day basis? One of the easiest ways to remember this is an archaeologist drips. And that's sort of a shorthand to remember that they discover, record, interpret, and protect. Right? Four things. And in doing that, the terms don't matter. It's the ideas. Step one, that you have to discover the site. You got to find it. And what we're going to find later is a lot of times it's an accident. Right? There are accidental discoveries right and left all the time. So the site is found. And then step two, you need to record it. This is so important. And you got one shot to record. Talk later why that is. But you got one shot. And what do I mean by record? You got to like write down paperwork about what you see at the moment. You can't be doing it at home the next day. You got to do it at the moment. This is taking photos. This is making drawings. And drawings, actually, when in doubt, are better than photos. But you want to do both. You might take a GPS point of where on Earth the site precisely is, so you must record. Super important. So after you've found the site, and after you've taken time, sometimes a lot of time, recording it, what are you going to do? You will interpret. That's part three. Interpret is telling the story of the past. You have these artifacts that you've found, right, at this site. What does it all mean? So it's up to you, as the archaeologist, to tell the story of 1,000 years ago, to interpret. And then finally, to protect, the last step. So after you've worked at this site, you want to protect it for the long term. This might mean something like covering it up. The general public doesn't realize how often we as archaeologists, we cover it up at the end. We don't expose it, usually, forever and ever, because the current environment can just basically wash it away. So you discover, you record, you interpret, and then you protect the site. And often that means having some money kept back in order for long-term preservation in some way. You want to preserve the artifacts, too, that you found. So there you go. Now, to break this down a bit further, I want to focus on the storytelling aspect of archaeology. Part three, right, this interpretation. Who cares about the interpretation part? What are you looking for? I find that there are three things. Three basic questions that almost every archaeology project is going to have to answer. And I like to shorten them by thinking TLC. So an archaeologist drips and they use a little TLC. What does TLC stand for? If you think about it, what do you think that an archaeology project or just the general public might be interested in an archaeological site? Okay, an archaeological site is found. What do you care about? What's the first question you ask usually? And it starts with T. It's timeline. And what I mean by that is, how old is it? Right, you want to know how old it is. That's kind of step one of the story. How long ago was this? How long were they there? Right, timeline. You want to reconstruct the timeline. And of course, this is going to dovetail into using carbon-14 dates and this kind of thing. So timeline is first. You want to know how old it is. Step two, L. It stands for lifeways. And what I mean by lifeways is, what did the people of the past do? What did these people who lived at this place, what did they do? What was their daily life like? How did they feel? How did they believe? How were they structured? What did they wear? What did they eat? A lot of that cultural anthropology stuff focused on the ancient past. The lifeways, the everyday life of these people. Finally, C, change. Change over time. A lot of times in archaeology, when you're working at a site, you'll see that something crazy happened. You know, they lived there, and then they didn't. They used to stay here, and then everyone moved over here. Right? This kind of thing. There'll be some sort of massive change that you'll see pretty easily in the archaeological record. Wow, they used to be hunters and gatherers, and then they grew corn. What? Right? Oh, it looks like they used to have a pretty good quality of life, and now there's a lot of dead people. So change over time. Very interesting, right? What happened here? Why did this become this? So there you go, right? That's what an archaeologist does. They find sites in the discovery phase, they record them, they interpret them, and often in the interpretation, you look at timeline, you're looking at lifeways, you're looking at change over time, and then after you figure that out, ultimately, you preserve the site.